Oh, hey, it's me, Jeff from Hot Tub Owner HQ. And I was just sort of rummaging around underneath my deck, thinking about how much weight can this deck really hold? Have you ever thought about that? Well, if you have a hot tub and you want to put it on a wooden deck, it's an important thing to know and to think about and to check out before you put your hot tub down. And that's what we're talking about today in this video. But first, I think I need to not be rummaging around under my deck. I'll be right back. Okay, that's a little better. So we're standing here on my deck, as you can see, and my hot tub is behind me. And as you notice, it's stepped down from the level that I'm at. And that is to help with the deck being able to support the weight. But even under my hot tub, as we're going to see in a minute, I still have added supports there that I don't need everywhere else, even at that lower height. But that's what we're talking about today in this video. Whether or not a deck can support a hot tub, how to know if yours can, and how to reinforce yours if it can't. We're going to cover all that and more, so stay tuned. So first of all, know that if your deck is just slightly above ground or at least under 2 feet off the ground, chances are it can support the weight of a hot tub without any additional support needed. Those kinds of decks can often support up to 100 pounds per square inch, and that's usually just fine for most small and medium-sized hot tubs, even a large one, as long as you don't pack it out with 8 people. But don't worry, we're going to get into some specific calculations about that, as well as some specific configurations a little bit later in the video. Okay, so the first thing we have to look at is the different sizes of hot tub and how much they weigh full of water and people. After all, we have to know the maximum weight if we can determine whether or not your deck can support that weight without any additional support needed. So a small 2 to 3 person hot tub is going to weigh about 3,000 pounds once you fill it up. Medium-sized hot tubs that hold about 4 to 5 people are going to be around 4,400 pounds. And large hot tubs that hold 6 to 8 people can be upwards of 5,500 pounds, maybe even as much as 6,000 pounds. And inflatable hot tubs, which we'll go into greater detail on here in a little bit, can be as much as 3,700 pounds for a large one, again, full of water and people. So those are pretty important numbers to know. Obviously, it's not specific to your make and model, but it should give you a pretty close ballpark. Okay, now the next thing I'm going to review is a calculation. And I know, if you're anything like me, and especially my wife, the mention of the word calculation is going to send you running out the door. So bear with me. This is an important calculation to know if you want to be safe in figuring out whether your deck can take the weight of a hot tub. So first, we need to know the weight of the hot tub empty. For a large hot tub, that's going to be about 800 pounds. Refer to the chart I showed you earlier that shows weight not only with water and people, but also empty. Next, we need to know the number of gallons of water that your hot tub holds, approximately. Again, for a large 6 to 8 person hot tub, that's about 525 gallons. We're going to multiply the number of gallons by 8.34. That's how much a gallon weighs. So again, for this same size hot tub we're talking about, that's 4,378.5. Then we add those two numbers together. The original number, which was 800, and the weight of the water, which is 4,378.5. Those two numbers added together are 5,178.5. Now we need to add the total maximum number of people that you might have in your hot tub at any one time. I know for me, oftentimes it's just me and my youngest daughter, or maybe my wife and I, or maybe 3 or 4 of us. It's very rarely all 5 of us in the Campbell clan. However, we want to know this just to be on the safe side in case you ever do max it out. So we're going to use 8 as the maximum number of people, and we're going to go with 175 pounds being the average weight of a user. That's going to add an additional 1,400 pounds. Now we're going to add that to the previous number. So that gives us 6,578.5 pounds. Now we're going to divide that by the number of square feet that the hot tub takes up. In this case, again, for a large hot tub, that's about 64 square feet.
So that calculation gives us 102.79. That's how many pounds per square foot that hot tub is going to deliver to your deck fully loaded. I mentioned earlier that hot tubs that are under 2 feet off of the ground can take 100 pounds per square foot. So this is slightly over that. So if you have a large hot tub that holds up to 8 people, it's probably worth the investment to add the additional support just to be safe. Again, most decks under 2 feet off the ground can take 100 pounds per square foot. But if it's anything above that, you're going to need that additional support. And as always, I am not a professional deck builder. I'm not a contractor. I'm not an inspector for your city or local county or whatever. I'm just a hot tub owner. And I can tell you what I've done with the deck that I built at my last home. And I can tell you what was done in this house where I live now with the deck that was here when I got here. I can show you what I've read online. But at the end of the day, if you need professional advice, you should seek out a professional in your area, because that is not me.
Okay, so I know we've covered a lot of ground in this video. I've gone over some complicated calculations that most of us have no business needing to know. But I also want to point out a few other simple tips. One is that Trex decking, which is that kind of composite decking that you sometimes see, basically, for lack of a better descriptor, it's fake plastic wood decking. But it does last a whole lot longer, which is why a lot of people like it. And it's also a little bit more expensive. However, in terms of supporting the weight of a hot tub, it is no stronger than regular wood. So if you have a Trex deck and you think, well, maybe this one will support the weight, just know that the calculations for weight, for figuring out the weight of a hot tub on your deck, are exactly the same no matter what kind of wood you're using, including the Trex composite decking. And now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, but Jeff, I have an inflatable hot tub. Surely that thing is flimsy. Surely I can put that on my deck. And the answer is maybe. However, just know that even an inflatable hot tub fully loaded with water and people can still weigh almost 4,000 pounds. That's a lot of weight. So it's too much of a risk to just chance it by throwing it out there and hoping it works. Go through the steps, figure out if your deck can take the weight, and figure out if you need to add the additional support. That way you can be safe, your friends can be safe, and your family can be safe. Okay, so this is underneath the main part of my deck. The main part of my deck is about 4 feet off the ground. And as you can see, I've got posts that are spread out every so often. And then I've got a few heavier duty ones as well. Now let's take a look at the decking under my hot tub. Okay, so this is the decking underneath my hot tub. My hot tub is right above us here. As you can see, every other post is one of these heavy duty, they're about 5.5 by 5.5. And then the smaller ones, as you can see here, are 3.5 by 3.5. You can also see that the posts are much closer together than they were in the main part of the deck. These are about 19 inches apart. And that one's 20. So you can see, and we'll go over this a little bit later in the video, I'll show you a detailed kind of blueprint of what to do and how this one was done. This one was done before I bought this house, so I had nothing to do with it. But I do know the correct way to brace up a deck to support the weight of a hot tub, and we're going to look at that here in a second.
Okay, so I've shown you underneath my deck, and I've told you that decks that are under 2 feet off of the ground can support up to 100 pounds per square inch. And I've also gone over that mind-numbing calculation that shows you how much your deck can support and how much your hot tub is going to add to the deck pressure per square foot. So now I want to show you the diagram. This is specific to what is going on at my house. Again, this was here when I got here. It's not something that I did. So normally those deck posts would probably be about every 4 or maybe even as much as 6 feet apart from one another, depending upon how high the deck is off of the ground. And then you've got the additional supports underneath the hot tub area that are probably needing to be between 20 and 30 inches apart. Again, you want to consult with an expert in your area, maybe a general contractor, the city planning office. Find out what is required in your area. But that is generally what is going to be deemed acceptable by most people, and that's definitely going to be enough to support the weight of a fully loaded hot tub.
Anyway, as I mentioned, my name is Jeff Campbell. This is my channel, Hot Tub Owner HQ. I would love it if you gave me a thumbs up. I really appreciate the support, and it helps YouTube know to show my content to more people. The more thumbs up I get, the more people that come to my channel, so I really appreciate that. Also, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification button. That way you get notified of future videos like this one. If you have something you'd like to see in a future video or something you weren't crazy about, leave me a comment down below. I will do my best to respond to every comment I get, even the constructively critical ones. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one.